What is up, YouTube? Terminal here. Today I want to talk to you about what I want to change and my main impressions from the pre-order beta. Stuff I like, stuff I dislike, and things like that, yeah. Overall, my thoughts on the beta. I have in the background just some matches I played. A really good Kitana player came up with some cool shit, so I said I'd just show it here while I'm speaking about this. Yeah. First of all, main impressions from the beta, it was a ton of fun. This game, in my opinion, has the potential to be the best fighting game, not just of this generation, ever. Not only an MK game, the best fighting game in general of all time. It feels... my main thing that I really liked are mainly the combos and especially how free they are. Like, they weren't lying when they said, we want this game to be free. They really made this game extreme combo freedom. You can pretty much do whatever you feel like doing. Be it a 50% combo, spending all of your bar, or just doing some cool stuff on the fly. There are a lot of cool shit you can come up with, and the game just feels really, really, really free in that department, so I don't think it's gonna get old anytime soon. Like, you can still... I'm still coming up with new stuff for Johnny Cage, even though I've been playing since the beta came out pretty much religiously, almost only Johnny Cage. And I still come up with stuff, I still find out stuff other people saw, so... yeah, I really, really do like the freedom and the diversity. And now, another thing I really, really like is the cameo system. Mortal Kombat especially, I always felt it was lacking in the department of, like, screen control. You always had zoners. Like, broken zoners, like MK9 Kenshi, MKX Jackie, with the auto machine gun, I don't know what the variation was. The one when she shoots tons of bullets at you. And you had Jade in MK11, but I never felt like you could actually control the screen to play the game as you want to play it. I felt like you could just zone and know your opponent out into quitting, but I never felt like you could control the game. In this game though, because of the cameos, I feel like you can really, really put the pressure on your opponent and you can really control the screen all over. Like with Lee Mei, for example, if you run with Frost, you can do the ground twist on full screen and launch the lantern at the same time. So you cover the ground and the air, so they have to be much more careful. Stuff like that really makes me love the cameo system. More than that, it's just the combos. The combos are amazing with the cameos. Like, yeah, you saw what I did with Johnny. I hope you saw what I did with Johnny and the Kano cameo. And it's just, it's ridiculous the combo potential you can get. But with that, there are also some stuff I don't like that I will talk about the individual cameos later, what I feel like could be changed about them, what they did right with them. But in general, the cameo system, my main worry is just that it's gonna be too broken. Like broken MK9 level Cyrex reset level broken, because we can see even with the simpler cameos we have now, none of them really have a cool, a new unique gimmick. They all just have certain moves there. Frost is the only one that has the freezing, because she's a cryomancer, but other than her, all of them just do regular attacks, so we can't judge it yet. But my main worry is, let's say a cameo, for example, if he was a cameo, Geras, who can freeze time, for example, stuff like that. So that worries me, because if we do get cameos like that, they could be really, really broken, and it would ruin the diversity. But yeah, that's pretty much it for cameos, and the final thing I really do enjoy is that even if you play one main character all the time, if you switch around the cameos, they never get old. Like, if I use Johnny and I use him with Frost, for example, instead of Kano, even though you shouldn't, Kano is the best of the options we have right now, but if I use Johnny with a different cameo, trying to come up with cool new combos, stuff like that, it really brings more diversity to the character you're already maining, so it's a lot of fun, and you can keep going with the same character you love, or with the same cameo you love, by switching your main character. So I feel like this game is not one of the games that's where the roster will get old eventually. Like, multiple years from now, you can still find some cool new shit with characters and cameo combinations. So yeah, the cameo system I really do think has a ton of potential, and for now at least, I feel like it's really, really well executed. Though I will say, one thing I kind of dislike about them is... never mind, I forgot what I wanted to say though. Anyways, moving on from the cameo system, I'll speak about the individual cameos later as I said, but now, if we're talking about core gameplay, I really, really enjoyed the gameplay. I enjoyed the gameplay still. even though the beta is like what, 1 hour I think. So not much time left, but I'm recording this right now. And yeah, when it comes to core gameplay, I have a few main critiques. First of all, I think the first hit buff, or like when you get another bar of meter for landing the first attack, it shouldn't count for grabs and it shouldn't count for pokes. Because these things really shouldn't count as hits, they're like, they're scratching the surface of a hit. Like a poke, you can just throw it around randomly and that's what people do. Pokes are broken and they need some changing again. They're not broken, they're just annoying. So I'll speak about what I wanted them changed later, but in general, I feel like the first hit buffer should be for the first combo, not for the first attack you do. Like if you land the full combo, more than one attack, that is not a grab, then you should get the buff on the meter, because it's really easy to just poke somebody out with a down one when they're mixing you up and you just get the bar for free when you shoot them. So yeah, that's something I want to see changed. Another thing I want to see changed is the pokes. As I said, pokes in this game, there's something I don't like about them, that's mainly their startup. They are ridiculously fast to the point where even if you are plus on block in some things, like let's say Liu Kang standing 3-2, the one where he just launches a huge fireball overhead at you. That one, it's plus 3 and people still manage to poke me out of it or out of my pressure, even though I do the 6 frame move afterwards. So I'm not sure how fast it is, but it's ridiculously fast. Way too fast for my liking. And it's also another thing with that is frame data in general. Like characters like Johnny Cage, I feel like should get their frame data nerfed, because you can really throw down one after any string you do and the opponent can't interrupt you. I've been trying with any character. Liu Kang is the fastest normal, I'm pretty sure, at 6 frames. The fastest a normal can get pretty much, and they can still poke me out of it. So I really don't know what you can do about it, but the only way to interrupt strings seems to be with other down ones. And that's not good, because it's really reminding me of something I hated in MK11 that was just poke mashing. And that sucks. So yeah, that's basically it for the pokes. Now, if we're talking about universal changes, that's basically all I have for the universal changes. Right now, that's all I can think about on the fly. And now, I want to move on to individual stuff, like individual characters. That will be the bulk of this video, pretty much. Also, one thing I wanted to mention. In the stress test, many people, myself included, just really hated the movement speed. Like, it was too slow, it was sluggish, and it makes you feel that the game would be really heavy on zoning, like Injustices. So something they did really well is adding like the block dashing like in MK9, so the movement is much better now. So that's something they just dropped for, in my opinion, so it's a really good thing. As you can see, the Kitana combo, you know, that was really cool. Like, my jaw dropped when I saw that. I didn't know you can loop those things. Really cool. Never mind that. So the dashing, it's really, really improved. The movement is improved. Like, I see people, I got myself a really good Liu Kang player. He was micro dashing to avoid the jumping attack and then punishing before it. So the movement feels much more diverse and much more skill reliant. So it's much more fun like that. Though I will say, I wouldn't mind the dashes were slightly faster. I don't really care, but I really don't mind. I feel like the movement should stay as it is right now, because if they try to change anything, they can make something really broken or just ruin what they already made, the progress they made. So I'm okay with the movement staying as it is right now. The movement feels like new, it feels natural, it doesn't feel too fast forward, but it also doesn't feel sluggish and slow, so it's a very good baseline to stay around, in my opinion, at least for now. We'll see if the full roster comes out, if characters will be extremely broken rushdown wise and they need to nerf the movement. But that's for next, that we only know that with the future. So yeah, moving on to individual characters, first of all, let's talk about somebody I have the least amount of critique for, possibly. Li Mei. Yeah, Li Mei, as I see, I'm playing her. Overall, I really, really like this character. I think her combos are extremely fun, like with the freeze and the double lantern. These things are really cool. She has some room for diversity, in my opinion. She's not as diverse as other characters like Johnny Cage, who just has an infinite combo right now. She really is a fun character. She excels all around, like she's good at everywhere, in every place. In mid range she's good, her frame data is spectacular, but doesn't feel broken because her hits don't lead to as much oppression like Johnny does. So I feel like her frame data is good, is really, really good, like she's plus on the many strings, but I feel like it's fair, it's not broken or anything. I feel like she's a really fun character. Though I will say, she has one move that I'm not really sure what's her purpose, like the special move where she flips the down back three. Roshi does the flip. I know it's an armor move, but I'm pretty sure the dash, the lunge that is flying Nishi does, the EX version is also an armor move, and it's also armor, so I'm not sure what's the point of that move. So I would really love it if they could do the EX, maybe make it a launcher, like for more combos, like Johnny's Rising Star, for example. Or just give him more combo diversity, more damage for more meter and stuff like that. So yeah, overall, Li Mei, I really, really like her. Great character in my opinion. Great voice acting on her too. Smooth animations, really, really natural, neutral feeling. Like her movements feel human, they don't feel like they're too fast or too slow. So I really love her. And yeah, moving on from her, I'll go with Kitana, like get the girls out first. Kitana, I feel like she wasn't strong enough in this game, in this build at least. Main critical F for Kitana is mainly just... Kitana doesn't reward you very much for relenting a hit, like, she also struggles in my opinion in mix-up department from what I could see. She has no overhead starters, and her frame data is really not that good. She's fairly unsafe on many of her frames, and they're also pretty slow, so... Kitana suffers in the footies game. So that's something they need to change in my opinion, like buff her strings a bit, give her more frame data. They can take some from Johnny, he is broken anyway, so... Yeah, I really like Johnny, I don't want it to sound like I hate on the character, but when I was playing against him, I could understand what my opponents were feeling. I had multiple people quit against me because Johnny is just ridiculous, man. But I'll get into Johnny later. But Kitana specifically... I really, really like her combos. I feel like her wind bomb has a ton of potential. When we get another cameo, something like Frost with a freeze, but the cameo is not a summon, it's an ambush, then we can see Kitana going crazy with the wind bombs, because you can get like 3 or 4 in the same combo with the right cameo, in my opinion, in the future. Right now you can't. My best I could do is 1, but as you can see, the Kitana I'm showing right here, the player came up with some cool stuff with Sonya. So I really, really like Kitana as a gameplay standpoint, but I feel like she's not strong enough. She should get some buffs. Her strings mainly suck in my opinion, just she doesn't really have good strings in general. None of her strings are really great. Not in the range, in the frame data, frame advantage. In all departments she really is spectacular. Alright, next up we want Kitana. If we talk about specials, I feel like a square wave is not that useful from what I saw. Like, it's a movement with great movement, like she covers pretty much half screen when you use it, but in combos she has like the Johnny Cage height meter stuff where you can special cancel into other specials with the enhanced version, but it's not very useful from what I saw. So I would love if they could maybe make it crumble, or maybe make it a restand or something like that, give her more combo potential, which would be nice. What more do we have? The EX Phantos, the standing one, which it rolls double fans and they just circle it like the tornado. I feel like it's way too slow. Even if you set it up with a wind bomb, it's really hard to land that hit. So I feel like it should combo with their strings instead of just comboing from specials. So that's another thing about her. The tornado she has, I really like how you can combo the EX in the normal version, like in the same combo, you can do it twice. I really like that as a standpoint, and it's good that he can do the tornado multiple times, because it will give her infinite combos pretty much. Yeah, that's pretty much it for Kitana in my opinion. The wind bomb is really, really cool. I really hope to see some cool stuff coming up. Maybe Kitana Pros will learn some stuff with her, and will show us some cool source, because I'm pretty sure she has the most potential after every character. Like, with most of them, with the other 5 characters, they pretty much covered most of the stuff they can do in my opinion, but... With Kitana, I feel like we didn't even scratch the surface, so... Yeah, we'll need to see how she works with other cameos. And overall, she's really, really fun. I love her. But she needs buffs, as I said. She's not strong enough. Especially in the strings. Her strings are not good enough. Alright, moving on. The first guy character we have, the first male. Who do I want to cover first? Let's say Kenshi. Now, Kenshi is extremely strong in the right hands, but there's something I didn't like. Like, if you saw Sonic Fox's gameplay when he first got his hands on Kenshi, you could see he was comboing into the Sento stance and still continuing the combo. Like, I know it's possible with the Frost cameo, but with the Kano cameo like Sonic Fox did it, I'm not sure it's possible anymore. I think it drops for some reason. And I don't really like that, because Sento stance is really not that powerful in my opinion. Like, offensively it's broken, you do a shit ton of damage, but first of all it requires execution, so it's only natural that you get rewarded for doing something difficult. So Kenshi really, his center stance is not that powerful in my opinion. Even though you can get a ton of damage with Kenshi, still, getting into the center stance, especially getting out, if you want to get out and play that zoning game to just get your opponent down on HP, it's really really hard to get out of center stance. That was my main critique with it. They need to make the quitting animation, like the animation will return to normal mode from center stance, they need to make it much faster, like the cancelling of the center stance is... Even if you're full screen, your opponent can punish you most of the time, it's ridiculously slow. They need to give it much more much faster recovery, like, it's ridiculous, you can't really get out of it. Another thing with center stance, that because of that I think maybe they just make the cancel instantaneous, like one frame. Because in center stance you actually lose your armor wake up, and armored wake-ups are a big thing in this game. Because of the cameos, you really get pretty much impossible to block situations sometimes, and if not, then some insane setups like the Jax ground pound with Liu Kang and stuff like that. So with Kenshi specifically, if he doesn't have an armor move in general, I feel like he should be capable of switching from center, like when you drop him to the ground. If you land the hit on Kenshi and you get him in a knockdown, he switches automatically back to his normal state. Like the sword just, he sits the sword on the ground, like he returns it to his place and he goes back to normal mode, only has the rising karma, the push, the armored special, like that gives him more opportunities, because you really don't want to go into Sento in a defensive state. Sento is just, you get a combo in, you get into Sento and you just shred their life bar, finish the round and go back to normal mode to do it again. Like, Sento stats really isn't good when you're getting attacked by your opponent, so you really don't want to be in Sento stance. So that's another thing with Kenshi, I really really wish they just make it so if your enemy lands a combo and knocks you down to the ground, you just lose the Sento stance. It cancels automatically. Another thing with Kenshi, again I mentioned, I wish you could still combo into the Sento, like with the Kano cameo. I don't know, with Frost I saw it's possible, but I really like the Kano cameo, because the string where you get it is actually insanely tough to get. Like it's a mid string, it's not that fast, so you won't catch your opponent with it most of the time. So I feel like getting to combo into the Sento stance and then moving from the combo into the setup, I feel like it's balanced for Sento, because really Kenshi requires extremely high execution. I don't think people understand that. His combos are mainly muscle memory, yeah, but his combos aren't that difficult, I will say that, but the main thing with them is the spacing, like getting the puppet where you need them to be, getting Kenshi where you need him to be, getting the combos in general, the combos aren't that easy. They're fairly difficult. Not that difficult, but not that very easy either. And I feel like Kenshi would really benefit from Kenshi really benefits from getting buffs to quality of life changes mainly, just frame data, stuff like that. Mainly around the center stance and cancelling the center stance, because Sento is really really, if you're on the defense in center mode, you're pretty much lost the round, like you can't get up, like you have no armor special, you lose your zoning option other than that EX move, but you don't want to spend bar to zone the Kenshi, especially when he has the demon drop that is fucking broken, so you really don't want to be in that position. So yeah, that's it for Kenshi. I feel like he's a character that really rewards you for being a good player, and that's a very good thing in my book. Like, the better you are, you should get more rewards from the character, so that's amazing. And that's something I really like about Kenshi. Like, you could see someone like Sonic Fox playing, he just is invincible with Kenshi, because he's actually good. So he deserves to be invincible, basically, in my opinion. Because Kenshi requires high execution. So yeah, that's it for Kenshi, amazing character, first puppet character in the history of Mortal Kombat by the way, so a very monumental occasion. So I really really love him, as I said. And now moving on, let's talk about Sub-Zero. Sub-Zero in this game is fairly straightforward, honestly, he just excels in everything, just like Lin-A, he's really good all around. So I will say, he's mixed up, I was expecting him to have like broken 50-50s like last year, like unreactable bullshit, but he actually doesn't have them. I feel like they could make it over a bit faster, like the one enemy taps you the spine, like it's 24 frames on startup, so it's very slow. And it's extremely punishable on block, so just make it faster, a bit faster in my opinion, though. That could backfire easily, because it can just be broken again, but I don't mind, it's Sub-Zero, is iconic, he needs to be really strong, same thing for Scorpion, like goated character, and be honest, is Sub-Zero after 30 years of being Luke Zybot, so give the man some slack, cut the man some slack and give him some broken stuff, I don't mind. With Sub-Zero, main thing I love is his combos, they are really fun, really really fun. He has a lot of damage, ridiculous amounts, like you can get consistent 45% for one bar sometimes, it's really really crazy. As for his cameo options, in this build he really didn't have a good cameo for him. Sonya was decent to get combos from his low starters, but I feel like she's not that good either. Maybe when the full game releases, we'll see some cameos that are much better for Sub-Zero. But another thing I dislike is the enhanced ice clone. It takes 2 bars for some reason, and I don't think it's that powerful to warrant it taking 2 bars. Like, I feel like it should take 1 bar, and it would be fair. And the slide is actually not that powerful in this game. I don't mind it, honestly, but the slide really is not that powerful. So that's a good thing in my book, because people just love to randomly throw slides, myself included. It's just an instinct when you play Sub-Zero at this point. So yeah, another thing, the ice ball could be a bit faster in my opinion for Sub-Zero. Like, they could make the ice ball a bit faster. And the enhanced ice ball especially, I think they're the same speed, the enhanced and the regular version, they should just make the enhanced one faster. But why not? I mean, it's enhanced, you lose a bar for it, so give him some rewards for it, other than going through a projectile and doing a bit damage. So yeah, that's gonna cut it for Sub-Zero in my opinion. I really love his design this year, like, it doesn't feel as frustrating to play against or with as it did last year. It was just boring last year to play with and against, so... I'm saying last year, last game, sorry. In MK11. So Sub-Zero, again, Sub-Zero really fun in my opinion. I love his combos. I love his animations, they are really, really, they're gorgeous, his animations. All of them. And I don't really like this fatality. Just temping, it doesn't really matter for the gameplay, but I think it's decent, it's nothing special. Yeah, moving on, I wanna get it before this clip is over. It has 3 more minutes, the gameplay clip. So I'll move on from Sub-Zero. Really good, really cool. I can't wait to see what other good players will do with him. So yeah, Sub-Zero, really cool. Moving on. Now we have Liu Kang, fairly straightforward in this game. His damage output is actually fucking stupid, like the amount of damage the character can do is ridiculous. Like if he catches you with the corner, let's say you run the Jax cameo or something like that, or the Sonya cameo, whatever cameo you could want, even without a cameo at all, if you spend 1 bar, or even if you don't spend bar, you can get 40% easily. And with 1 bar or 2 bars you can get 50% also, it's just, it's crazy. But one thing I don't like about Liu Kang, he really really lacks mix-ups. Like, he's great at playing the footsies, but his mix is extremely weak. Like, he has no low starters, actually none, and also no overhead starters, so he really has no way of opening you up on the block. Unless he uses unblockable cameo or something like that, but it's not that good. Another thing about Liu Kang that I really didn't like is... Liu Kang also has a... What was I trying to say? Sorry, I lost my string of thought for a second. God damn it, what did I want to talk about? Ah, yeah. The enhanced dragon, the blue one, the launches. It's actually safe on block, I'm pretty sure. It's really, really safe. I'm pretty sure it's no more than minus 9, so... I don't like that. I feel like dragon is so broken on the enhanced version when you actually land it. Like, it gets stupid damage, so you should get punished for landing it on block. This is not a move you want to use on block, so it shouldn't be allowed to be done on block. So that is for Liu Kang in my opinion, but main thing I want to see is frame data is amazing, yes, but if they do give him some sort of low starter or just better mix-up overall, better mix options, I do want to see nerfing his frame data a bit, because his frame data is extremely strong, like it's ridiculously good. Pretty much everything he does is either plus or minus 2 or stuff like that, so Liu Kang is very strong. Overall, I really do like his combos, his black hole fatality, it's unrelated to the gameplay, but it's the best fatality I've ever seen in any game. Like, it's the best finishing move in any game I've ever seen, it's fucking amazing. So props to the team for that. Both of his fatalities are awesome, his animations are gorgeous. He feels in his animations, he just, his movements, his animations, his moves overall, he feels like a god, he feels very powerful. That's something I like. So yeah, that's pretty much it for Liu Kang. I really enjoyed playing him. And he has really fun combos, but I do wish he had more mix-ups. Like, at a high level, it really, really becomes a problem, because you can't just rely on catching your opponent in their mistakes, because he won't make that many mistakes eventually. Yeah, so that's it for Liu Kang. Now, the clip with the Kitana player just ended, so I'll add in another one. More gameplay. I have a shit ton of gameplay footage I recorded because I wanted to make sure I will have until MK1 comes out. So I have a lot of gameplay recording that's coming. I'm pretty sure it will last before the month. Now moving on to the main man. The main bastard. Johnny Cage. Now, Johnny is a ton of fun, don't get me wrong. It was my main. He's probably gonna stay my main, either him or Havoc, because I love Havoc. I love them in the 3D era as well. But Johnny Cage feels extremely overpowered, and the main reason for that is just his frame data is stupid. Like, Johnny Cage is unpunishable regardless of what he's doing, either than the forward 1-2-4, like the double overhead kick that launches. None of his strings are punishable, none of them. It's crazy for me because Johnny Cage is a ton of 50-50s. He has multiple 50-50s, and most of his strings are actually so safe that they're almost neutral on block, so you can just throw in pokes. That's what more Johnny players are doing. They just, like, is a 2-1-2 string where he launches you, they just stop with a 2-1, and they just poke. And you can't interrupt Johnny for some reason. I don't understand why his frame data is that powerful, but Johnny in general, his damage is ridiculously high with a KNO cameo, because you can get the wrist standing nut punch and you can get a shit ton of damage. The height meter, a cool mechanic. I love that Johnny has that, because it really fits for his character. You just flex on his opponent and just get stuff like that. So that's a really good thing I liked about Johnny. Now, before I move into other stuff I disliked about him, because there are a few, the thing I really liked about Johnny, multiple things actually. First of all, I love his taunt. Johnny Cage, other than Shao Kahn, feels like the most fitting character to just troll his opponent mid-match. Like, trash, you like what you see. The Van Damme pose after his shadow kick is a really cool touch, because he has a Van Damme skin in the full game. So I really did like that with Johnny Cage. Another thing I really like, the hype meter, it's so free. The combo freedom with Johnny is absolutely spectacular. Like, you do whatever you want and you can still get good damage and you can still play to win, but you can play to also do some swag shit on the fly. And that's just amazing in my book. I love characters that can do that. Johnny also, they made him a pure rush down, but they gave him the tools he needs to actually deal with zoners. Like, Liu Kang, for example, is pretty good full screen. It's really, really good full screen. Like, he's a crazy good zoner. And actually, they gave him the dash. The dash in general is not that good, but the enhanced dash is actually invincible, it turns out. So the enhanced dash is very good to deal with keep away. And when you have hype activated, actually the normal dash also becomes like the enhanced dash, and it can projectile immune. So it's a great thing for Johnny, because he can get in and out quickly, like the rush time character that he is. He doesn't want to be full screen, he wants to be on your face, beat the shit out of you, destroy you with resets, with mix-ups. And yeah, he does that extremely well. Now, a few more things I disliked about Johnny. That's moving on for the positive. Actually, a bit more positive, because why not? I really, really like how he synergizes with cameos. Like, Johnny, as a character, depending on the playstyle you choose to have and the cameo you pick, you can actually change his combos in a way that fits you without actually losing that much damage. Like, Kano was the highest damage out possible with Johnny Cage in this build, but someone like Sonya, if you want to run Sonya instead of Kano, you can run Sonya. And you can use the Rising Star as a combo extender instead of the enhanced stance punch, and you can still get really good damage. So that's a really good thing about Johnny. He has so many options offensively, that you can really pick your cameo based on preference, and not only based on that. Because Johnny doesn't need a cameo to be broken. Like, Johnny is just ridiculous all around, in my opinion. Especially now with his frame data. If his frame data got nerfed, it would be a different story. But I don't want them to nerf it to the ground, but I do want them to just make his strings a bit more fair. Like, I feel like a string that leads to 50% combos with a wrist and that more mixed up shouldn't be safe on block. Like, that's just my opinion. And a few more things about Johnny. The shades move, I want them to buff it in some way. Maybe make it a crumble. Like, they make his shades like a Lego piece where you just help the opponent and he crumbles to the ground and you get the combo. Like, some fun stuff like that, because the shades really feel useless. There is no usage for them at all. So they're just a troll move. I don't mind troll move, but I wish the troll move was actually good. Imagine how cool it would be if you could loop it 5 times in a combo using your cameos and actually kill with a brutality with the sunglasses. It would be so fucking fun. So yeah, I want him to buff this move, maybe it's frames, just give him... I don't want to give more combo potential to get stupid combos, but... if you saw my 60% Johnny combo, you can see Johnny really has insane combos. And that's something, that's the most fun thing about him, his combos are a lot of fun. His height meter is unique and it's actually really, really cool. And it's also designed in a way that doesn't feel extremely broken because it runs out fairly fast. Like if it, you got it and it would last for the entire round, it would be broken, but it actually charges pretty quickly and it also ends pretty quickly. So you get a burst of damage, a burst of mix-ups and a burst of safe frames, but it ends pretty quickly. So it's balanced in my opinion. Not that balanced, but not completely broken. So that's a good thing. I don't want the game to be too balanced. I want it to be broken in some area. Now, moving on to the negatives with Johnny, I'm taking a long time with Johnny because Johnny really has a lot, but main thing I disliked about him other than his frames, main thing I disliked was his fatal blow. It's ridiculously overpowered. It's way, way, way too strong. First of all, you can actually use it like a regular fatal. If you don't want to use it as a counter, you don't have to, you can just use it as fatal. Like it's 2-1 string when your opponent is standing, it combos into the fatal. So pretty straightforward, you can do it any way you'd like. So it's really easy to combo into it. And with a counter, you can hold it for an extremely long time. And that's something to keep in mind with Johnny. You can hold it for a lot of time, and I'm pretty sure when you release it at the end, it becomes unblockable. Like if you do the entire dumbass dance he does with his fatal blow and he actually lands the attack on the enemy, I'm pretty sure the attack itself is unblockable, so they have to get out of the way. But the main thing I really disliked about it was the fact he could cancel it. Like the cancels aren't reliant for his he isn't reliant on his cancels like in MK11 for his combo, so he really shouldn't be capable of canceling that. That's way over the top in my opinion. It's already a combo. It's already a fatal that combos, it's already a counter, you can already hold it for a shit ton of time, and I'm pretty sure it's unblockable at the end. Giving him the ability to cancel it into the shadow dash and then running away without getting any sort of punish, really dumb, really makes the game like you can just use it as a get out of jail card, just throw it randomly and then cancel into the dash and escape. Like these are things I really don't like about Johnny because he's so oppressive, he needs to be put on the defensive sometimes. But with this fatal he just feels invincible when he gets it, so... I want them to just take out the option to cancel it completely out. Like, he shouldn't be capable of canceling his fatal blow. So yeah, after a long time of talking about Johnny, that's pretty much it for Johnny. I really, really love him. It's the best Johnny Cage has ever been in a Mortal Kombat game, in my opinion. He feels really fun to play with. Not so fun to play against, mainly because his frames are stupid and his fatal is broken, but... And one more thing is a counter special, the one where it dashes out behind you and if you get a combo, they need to... change the animation to a way where you can actually see when the animation ends, like when the counter itself ends, because it just is stamped in the same pose and you can't tell when it ends actually, so we're afraid to attack him because he can hold it for as much as he wants. So that needs to change in my opinion. Just make him do some sort of animation. They need to make him do some sort of an animation when holding the counter down finishes and just like, I don't know, puts on his sunglasses or something like that, and that's an indicator that the counter ran out. So yeah, finally we're finished with the playable characters. Now I'll go over the cameos very quick, stuff I want to see changed about them, then I'll wrap this up. Really long video, but there is a lot to talk about in this beta. First of all, the most straightforward one in my opinion, Sonya. Just I really like Sonya's design with the square wave, just give you combos. That's a really fun thing. The leg grab, I feel like it's not that useful because it's too slow. I feel like they should make it a much faster startup. Or maybe even turn it into an ambush, like it doesn't have to be a summon, you don't need to do the animation for it in my opinion. They can make it like the square, you can just attack and summon it at the same time. It will give her much more combo potential, that's the point of that cameo. So I would really love to see her just getting that change from a summon to an ambush. Her energy rings, I feel like they could make the energy rings where you hold them down, they could make it actually a pop-up, like a crazy pop-up, like Lee May's lantern level. So you can just get a full combo even if you're far away, because you really don't have usage for that right now. But yeah, that's pretty much it for Sonya. Really cool. Like her. She has an amazing design as well. The OG design, the classic one, is really, really good for her. Still Ronda Rousey voicing her, and it's weird. But whatever. I mean, she didn't really do a bad job. I like her voice as Sonya, so I don't mind. Alright, next up, next cameo we have, I'll keep Frost for last because she has the most I want to talk about, but next up let's go with Jax. Main critique I have of Jax is the ground pound, that it actually stays on screen more than Tower Wonder one time. First of all, it's ridiculously bad for the player using Jax. If you're using the ground pound, you only use it in a setup like Liu Kang's, like when you do the flurry of kicks, and you get the ground pound and the jumping attack at the same time to get the reset. Like something like that. But Jax staying on screen and continuing to ground pound two more times is really, really bad for the player. Like, it's annoying, really. He also, most of the time, will just get hit. The enemy will attack Jax because he can, and Jax will then not be available for a long time. So that's really not good for the player. It makes Jax really weak. So they should just make it one time instead of him staying on screen and pounding the ground. It should be one ground pound and that's it. It disappears. His backbreaker, really cool, really good for combos. So one thing I do wish, they could make it so he launches them higher in the air after he finishes the backbreaker, but I don't mind it as the way it is now, it's still good. His final move, the one where you summon him, they could give it a bit more pushback, because I could see some people could punish me, like with Johnny's shadow kick, stuff like that. They should give it a bit more pushback, because that's the point, just stay safe with the mix, with this block string. So, yeah, Jax, really fun to use, hilarious fatality. It just gets giant and stops on them like a fly, it's hilarious. And again, a classic throwback. I love how the direction they took with the cameo fatalities is classic finishers. Really cool. Alright, next up. What other cameos? Sorry, I just forgot. Ah, yeah, okay, I forgot you, bastard. Kano. Yeah, Kano is stupid strong, man. Kano. The knife toss is extremely powerful with somebody like Johnny. Though I will say, I don't think Kano is broken, I think just he placed Johnny's strengths extremely well. I don't think there will be a better cameo for Johnny than Kano. Like, Kano can help you with full screen, he can help you keep yourself safe when you charge the hype meter with the Kano ball that you can hold and get some mix-ups. So, overall, I really like Kano. The laser where he stomps over yourself is really cool. Like, where he stomps over your character, I like it, really, really fits for Kano. His heart reaper fatality, I like it too. Honestly, just the way he beats the heart at the end, also cool. And Kano overall feels extremely strong, extremely fun to use, gives you a lot of combo potential, so yeah, 10 out of 10 for me for Kano. Now Frost. Frost is a tricky one. The ground freeze, in my opinion, is stupid strong. Like, I feel like they should nerf it a bit, like make the freeze not go full screen, because one thing that is really broken about it, even though it's a summon, Frost will actually serve as a human barrier to the actual character, so Frost can launch the ground freeze, it will freeze the enemy and they will hit you with the projectile, but Frost will absorb it for you. So you can actually freeze them and you can still move and get a full combo. So that's something to keep in mind. I think the easiest way to fix it is just make the freeze not go full screen. The freeze going full screen is pretty stupid in my opinion. It should go half screen in my opinion, half screen, maybe three quarters, but not the full screen. The full screen is too much. And now again, Frost, the main thing I didn't like about it is that all of her moves are summons, and that's really over the top of my opinion. Like the move which slams the ground and a glacier comes out, that should be an ambush. I don't see the point in making it a summon. Truly, I don't see the point. Her move where she does the flurry of punches, a very good move on block actually. It has a ton of pushdown. So really good for zoning characters, to keep yourself safe in block strikes, but that one I don't mind it being a summon, because it would be a bit too strong if it's an ambush because of the amount of time she keeps you in the air if you land it on an airborne opponent. So that's okay for me that it's a summon. Now the flying ice orb feels extremely strong, but I feel like it doesn't have a character that fits it yet, if you get what I'm saying. Like, there is no playable character, at least in this open beta, that really synergizes well with that move of Frost, where she launches that slow moving orb. Like, we need to wait for the full game, but I feel like the move has a lot of potential. But overall, it's Frost, I really like her for combos, like with Lin Mei, as you could see earlier. Lin Mei has some really good combos with Frost Freeze. And overall, she just synergizes really well with Lin Mei, especially in this build, at least. She synergizes really well with Kitana. She's a really cool cameo. I love her new design. It's been much better now that she's a human again, instead of being a nano robot machine, whatever. So yeah, that's first, and yeah, I'm gonna wrap this up over here. 40 minutes long, basically. Really long video, sorry about that, but again, there was a lot I wanted to cover. Overall, main thing I want to see, main changes I would love to see in the full game, again, the pokes, as I said, strain data for some characters, tweak it around a bit. And I want to see more cool characters, more unique stuff, and more, most importantly, more cool combos, because that's the best part about this game for sure. The combos are amazing. So yeah, that's gonna wrap it up. MK1 is awesome. Can't wait for the full release. Peace. See you next time.